Hi, I'm John Popovich, President and CEO of Henry Ford Hospital. We started back in July of 2010, created our team. We continue to build our team of close to 9,000 people here on campus. And I want to talk a little bit about what the year has been like. I want to change the culture of the organization. And oftentimes people would say, well, what's wrong with the culture of the organization? And I said, there's nothing wrong with the culture of the organization, but what I want to do is I want to create the concentration, and I want the feeling of each of the employees who work here that they understand and they live and they embody that culture on a day-to-day day-to-day basis. And what I've talked about, a lot about, is that we embody that with each patient, every encounter, every time that we see patients. And that's truly the transformative aspect of the culture. I'm very proud of the employees here. Whether it's in the community giving campaign, where we've got close to 60% of our employees who provide their own resources philanthropically to our organization, that's unique amongst most organizations. It shows that type of commitment. But it's part of that cultural ownership of this institution, which is so vital. Now, how have we translated that? We have had remarkable growth in certain areas that are very pivotal to capitalize on the strength of this organization. So we've got great training programs, we've got expert doctors and nurses and pharmacists and other technicians that really are as good as anywhere in the country. And we need to have that opportunity for patients from all over the state, all over the regions, and internationally to come to Henry Ford Hospital for that care. We've been concentrating on that because our volume is reduced in this hospital, and it's reduced for several reasons. One is that we've got a much smaller city than we were. We're about a third of the size of what this city used to be in terms of population. That's a remarkable change. There's no other city that has gone through that type of significant reduction. So we don't have necessarily growth of the population that normally comes to a hospital for community activities. And one thing that's been helpful for us to be able to provide that is our partnership with Superior Ambulance. And initially it was flying, it was red and white, but now it's blue and white. Says Henry Ford Hospital on it. And I have to report that as of this week, it also has the beautiful logo of the Henry Ford Medical Group on it, because Henry Ford Medical Group and Henry Ford Hospital are one. We've had a very, very good lift from that. So despite a diminishment in volume, we've been able to offset that by taking care of very sick patients that have grown our surgical volume by almost 8% in inpatient surgical volume. And our general volume from last year has also increased by several percent. So that has been our strategy, to utilize and leverage our strength as an integrated team of providers, of physicians from the medical group, and also the people from the experts from the hospital, the nurses and others, working together to take care of the sickest of the sick and really extend that to a much wider range of individuals. One tool that is used is actually to have an MRI machine within the surgical suite and within the operating room. So an intraoperative MRI. And what that allows to do, it allows a surgeon, rather than to guess the margins of a tumor, which oftentimes are very, very difficult to determine within the brain, they actually can do an operation and be able to then place the patient into the MRI and determine whether or not the entirety of that tumor is removed or not. Over the past year, what we've developed is a tremendous orientation toward medical innovation, and we wanted to create a site here on campus that would be a convening area and an opportunity for a variety of people from various sources, whether they be hospital personnel or clinic people or people, college students in the College of Creative Studies, or engineers at the and researchers in the engineering school, to get together and be able to create products and create design approaches. In October, we're going to be opening the Medical Innovation Center. And I have to say is that this will be a great focal point. It's really what we are in Detroit. We've got a lot of community development. And one of the things that I have to say that I under-recognized about this job is the amount of community activity which is done as CEO and president. We had breaking records on the Heart Walk, and it was beautiful for me because it allowed people to walk from Ford Field down to the riverfront area and then back down Woodward to actually see what this city can be. Because we don't walk in this city a great deal, and our view of this city is oftentimes no higher than looking out our car window until we get to a destination like Comerica Park or get to the DIA or get to a restaurant or somewhere else that we're going within the city. But when you walk and you experience the city and you experience the architecture and you see the rich grandeur, not only of the past, but what can be in the future, it offers us a glimpse of the future. And that future is largely what we're trying to create here at Henry Ford. We're trying to create our part, and a big part, we feel, of the future of this city. The other big community dealing that we had is that we had our first gala. And we had a gala at the MGM Grand Hotel in December. And Henry Ford Hospital has never had galas. We've had philanthropic events, and we generally have done that for certain types of services or groups, but we never had one which was truly a Henry Ford Hospital and Detroit campus event. But it shows you the draw of what Henry Ford Hospital is. We had a remarkable time. We had a remarkable time with Mayor Bing, who talked about the role of Henry Ford Hospital, his role within the city, the rebirth of the city. I had opportunity to talk about the vision of Henry Ford Hospital and where we're going, and really the spirit that I think that we can represent. And it was a magical night. I will say that all of my energies and all of my management team's energies will continue to drive this institution as a place of workplace joy, as a place in which employees not only are passionately engaged, but want to be part of the future of this organization and create the great work that we do, and have patients who come here, not because they have to come here, but they come here by choice because they're loyal, and they come here because they get services, and they come here because this is the place that can offer them the best opportunity to return to health and wellness. Thank you.